students, we will discuss an example of an octahedral, outer orbital complex, right? So here we will start with the configuration of iron. You know that iron, the atomic number is 26, right? Z equals to 26 for iron. So we can write it here as argon. It is 3d6 4s2, right? Now what is going to be the oxidation state of iron here? Since it is H2O whole 6, so it is X plus, H2O is a neutral ligand, so X plus 0 into 6 equals to plus 3. We will get here Fe plus 3, right? So if we write down the electronic configuration of Fe 3 plus, it will be, student, how much? So 4s2 plus 1 from here, it will be 3d5, right? So we will have outermost configuration to be 3d5, 4s0. So we will first write down here Fe configuration. So it is 3d. So it is how much? At first it is 6, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then come the 4s2, which is 4s, and this is the 4p, right? You can write down the ground state here also, right? I'm just writing here GS, which indicates the ground state. Now next is the excited state, or you can write down here the, since we are getting the oxidation state 3 here, so it is Fe3 positive. So students, if the 3 electrons are to be removed, first the 4s will get empty, right? And then there will be removal of 2 more electrons. So one from here, which was last filled. Right, so 2 from here and 1 from here, getting total 3. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is 4b. Now students, from here you can easily see that here the orbitals are filled up. Right, that means in this case we will be not getting the 3d subshell involved here in the bonding. So we need the, we have to show here 4d orbitals. So when we are showing the iron in its hybrid state, right, at that time, so it is here 5 filled up, this is 4s empty, this is 4p. Now this we have to show 4d, right? So this is 4d. It is also an empty till now, right? So it is 4s, now this is 4p. Now you will check that how much, what is the coordination number of iron here? It is 6 here. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is going to be the hybridization. So what it will be? It will be sp3d2. So here you can see that Nd subshell is being involved, or Nd orbitals are getting involved in the hybridization. So it will be known as sp3d2 hybridization. And at the end we will show the complex formation taking place. So this is 3d filled up, this is 4s, this is 4p and this is 4d. We are only involving this one. So here we can show 2 electrons from each ligand. Here the each ligand is water, so we will write down in this way. This is the electron pair which will be donated by each water molecule. So students, here the hybridization which is getting involved is sp3d2, right? and the empty orbitals are being provided with the electron pair by the water molecule. Now we are going to write down the characteristics which we can conclude from here. Right, student? So I'm going to write down the characteristic here of this complex, characteristics or the properties. The first is hybridization involved is sp3d2. Second is its geometry is going to be again octahedral, because d2sp3 or sp3d2 hybridization involves the octahedral geometry or shape. Third, since here nd, that is outer shell, right, outer shell d orbital is getting involved, it is known as the outer orbital complex, right, and it is again paramagnetic. As you can see here, the number of the unpaired electron is more, so it is the paramagnetic substance. And you can see that here the number of unpaired electron is maximum. The d subshell can have maximum 5 unpaired electron, so it is a high spin complex. So students, whenever we are having the outer orbital complex where we are getting nd orbitals involved in the hybridization, in that case the number of the unpaired electrons which we get is maximum, so it becomes a high spin, right, and the spin of the unpaired electron will be high. That's why it is a high spin complex, right? When we have got maximum number of unpaired electrons, it forms the, and it is outer orbital complex, it forms the high spin complex. Yes, friends. So today we have discussed these complexes which have the coordination number 6, right, and which forms either inner orbital complex or the outer orbital complex. In the next class, we will discuss the complexes where the coordination number is going to be 4 and 5, right? Till then, just practice these type of examples.